guys and gals, I'm here with a new video. And today, I'm here to talk to you about my thoughts on Masterpiece 24 Star Saber. It took 6 tries to get that right. Who would have thought saying, hey guys and gals, would be so difficult? But of course, here's the box. It is what you would expect from a Masterpiece box. What you would expect. There's not, it shows what I'm going to talk about. It has instructions. The one cute thing I like about the instructions is the back, where it shows the progression of Star Saber, including the Armada sword made of Minicons. Aww. And he has a card. If you are at all curious, there are his little tech specs. Yay. Once you have the box opened up, you of course have Saber. And then the V-Star. So I've already got them transformed separately. They are combined. Or are they combined? They might be combined. Your landing gear wasn't all the way down. Why are you... Oh, because one landing gear really wasn't down. I'm an idiot. And of course, you have a bunch of accessories. So who doesn't love accessories? They're the best things ever. You have the shield, which I'm going to go ahead and attach these. You have 2 options for the shield. One, you can use it, of course, as a shield. And then you can take these pieces, and this will actually make a somewhat flight stand. It's not so much a flight stand, just a stand for the actual vehicle modes of them all. So that's a really neat little feature. So I got that all set up. And of course, that is the adapter for the robot mode. You have 2 blades for the saber sword. Whew, so many sabers today. You're going to be surprised. Which I do like. 1 for saber and 1 for star saber. You have a small hilt that works for both modes. And of course, you have the saber laser, which has a peg to store in vehicle mode and in the back of star saber. And then a handle for both of the robot modes. And last but not least, you have this little adapter, which will turn the larger hilt into a 2-handed sword. A lot of accessories. You can actually store these, for the most part, on the V-Star. So all you do, you flip these little panels up, and that will allow you to slot in the large sword. Yup. Like that. And then the smaller sword. Yup. Just like that. You can take the gun, it kind of mounts on the back there. I do wish the little hole for the gun mount was actually deeper. That panel is popping up, and I do not appreciate that. Because the gun kind of sits a little high, and it's not a secure fit. I wish it actually pegged in a lot better. And you can take the hilt and store it under this little hole in the back, which I'm going to do off camera because it is kind of finicky unless I take the whole thing apart. This really won't work for robot mode. It's just for vehicle mode. And there we go. I finally worked it in place. So it stores right in there. And then, of course, you can take this big guy. I think it depends on which way you're going to put it on. I think if you're putting it on, it works to have this little back piece tabbed in first. No. When you're putting it on, you do the front first. Just kind of loop it around the crotch piece. And then clip it in. And then when you're taking it off, I guess it works to do the front. I don't know. But anyway, that is a cool accessory to have. They did not have to do that. It does leave these guys just kind of hanging out doing nothing. But there's the V-Star on its little stand. And it supports it pretty well. It's good. These pieces do come untabbed quite easily. So let me just get those right back in place and hope it stays. And then, of course, you can take the landing gears of the V-Star. They just fold up like that, and that's going to fold up. That folds away. If you want to pull it out again, you just pull this little red panel, flip the wheel up, and you're good to go. So there's that. And you're going to take these guys, fold the wheels in, fold those panels over. Take those wheels, fold them in, fold it over. A V-Star itself does have some missile pods. You kind of have to take this guy, bring it out, and then bring it up. You have some missile pods on each side, which is, quite handy. It's nice to have a giant ship that has missile pods. Now, before I do get to the rest of everything else, I will say this Masterpiece is kind of a mixed bag. It really feels like they put all of their effort into Saber himself and then kind of just worked around it for the actual V-Star, for the Star Saber configuration. When you look at Saber, he's got some really nice, intricate details, and he looks nice. There's a lot going on. There's not too much kind of bland, flat plastic going on. When you compare it to the actual V-Star, though, there's nothing but flat plastic. There are some vents here and there, some little detail, but overall, this toy really reminds me of the Mani Collector Voltron lines, where it was just really big, thick plastic. Not a bad thing, a strong plastic, but it's just there's not a lot of detail going on. The plastic is actually molded in its color. There's not too many paint apps that I can really spot. So It's kind of a mixed bag. It looks nice. It is faithful to the animation. I think it's faithful to the quote-unquote G1 toy. G1ers are going to freak out because it's not G1. It's totally not G1. It's something else entirely. But I do get kind of like an eh. When you compare this guy to MP10, it really does feel bland. And I'm not sure what Repro Labels could really do to spruce it up, but I am eager to see it. So there's all of that. Now for the Saber, I almost called it the V-Star. You, of course, have landing gears as well. Those fold away, just like that. The wings, you can have the little tail section up right this. You can have it angled down. You can kind of go for like an X-Wing vibe and have them kind of in that configuration. It's totally up to you. It is your toy. The cockpit does open up, if I can get my nail inside there, where you can store the Brain of Courage, the Brain Master for all of this. And I can't help but like how much detail is included. This is going to be very, very hard to show off because he is so utterly tiny. But they really did a nice amount of detail on him. And his arms and legs are actually articulated. So just to give you an idea, that's just so tiny. He's definitely smaller than your typical headmaster. But he does resemble Star Saber's overall combined look in terms of his appearance. I'm going to go ahead. I think I'll leave them out for now, just for the time being. So you can, of course, take these guys and combine them for their super ultra mode. You're going to take the tail wings. You're going to fold them down. You're going to take the front wings. They're going to fold up like this. When you grab the whole unit, there is this little kind of a lever inside, and there's a button on the back. And I almost killed Saber. When you push this button, it'll wiggle that around. And that helps a little bit when you're setting up their combined modes. It's not drastically an improvement, but it's there to kind of help you out. You're going to take this little square peg, and that's going to fit over that square hole in square peg. You're going to line those up first, and once you get it flat, you can kind of tell from the base how it connects. You can push up, make sure the wings are not in the way. You can push up, and it should click in place. And you're going to take these little panels, and they're going to fold over. And there you go. There is Star Saber in its combined vehicle mode. And that looks really, really cool. To give you an idea of just how big this thing is. Here it is next to MP10. And I think these guys look really nice together. And it's partly because of their overall color scheme being somewhat similar. But this is a really nice big masterpiece. It's the last masterpiece that I've gotten since, I think, Soundwave. So I haven't tackled the Ultra Magnus and the other, any of that stuff yet. But there you go. There is it. It's in its combined mode. And I think it looks really, really nice. I like all the little thrusters. I think all the thrusters are actually die-cast. There is some die-cast on this guy. I cannot tell you what all is and isn't die-cast. I don't know. But again, you can take Saber, undo the little gray panels, pull them down. He just comes out like that. And I think that's really it for that mode. So to get this guy transformed into its Saber robot mode, transector mode, whatever. I've seen like 3 episodes of Victory. I've tried to watch Victory, and I'm glad that I did. It's a neat little show. You're gonna take the wings. They're gonna fold over just like this. You're gonna take the tail fins, and they're gonna fold over like that. You're gonna push down the landing gears to bring out the feetums, which that one's kind of stuck. There we go. And next you're gonna take off this whole nose cone. That will be the hilt for the saber sword for its larger mode. And you got this little empty chasm. What's going on there? I don't know. You're going to take the arms. They're going to fold up like that. Get them going. Kind of get them out of the way. I like separating the legs before I pull them down. It seems trickier when you do them together. You're just going to give a really nice tug until it's all the way down. Until you can see those little black vents. You think... Oh, actually, look at that. I didn't pull this all the way down. It feels like I did, but I didn't. There are clearly more vents showing on that leg. Problem solved. And you have to kind of straighten the legs up due to how it transforms for his jet mode. It kind of helps to bring them forward a little bit and just to get those lined up. I will say the ratchets on this guy are kind of weird. When you're bringing his legs forward, you have really tough ratchets that almost sound too strong. When you're bringing them back, you have very, very light. It kind of feels like it should be reversed due to how it combines to the robot mode, unless maybe you're supposed to flip them around the opposite way. I haven't tried that yet. We'll see what happens. But there's that. Take the arms. They're going to fold outwards and then go down. You're going to fold out the little hands. This side, fold out the arms. Whoop. And there's the little hands. Now, of course, the whole gimmick for the Brain Master thing, which I think is just really, really neat the way they did. This is my first Brain Master. You take his little chest. It's going to fold down. You have this nice little seat inside. Now, the Brain of Courage has a hole in the back. There's a little peg right inside there. You have to kind of line those up. And I think I actually did it. Yay. And once he's inside, I love this gimmick. Whoop.
Hello there.
And the neat thing is also you have to take the cockpit, push it back. The head actually does have articulation. So even, it has this really cool gimmick, and the head can still turn left and right. Now, it can't do a full 360 from what I've seen, it can't. And it can't look up and down, so you are a bit limited. But the fact that there actually is articulation really does woo me. So get you standing there. Of course, you take this nose cone. You're going to fold this piece down. There are little divots on the side there and little notches on that. So you're going to put those together. And that should go on just like that. And then you have Saber in his combined, well, not his combined mode, his robot mode. He's leaning back really, really weird. His ratchets are just, are kind of strange. I don't know. It feels wrong. Feels like it's not right. He is leaning back kind of funny because, again, my table is slanted. But this is a really cool robot mode. I like how this guy looks a lot. It works for me on so many levels. And he's kind of leaning back, but whatever. Articulation-wise for him, he does have movement in his arms. However, these little parts of his wings do limit how far his arms can move. So you can't only go that high. Unless you kind of reposition them a little bit, you can get them going a bit higher. But you do have to kind of move them past this little upper part of the wing. He does have elbows. He does have a bicep swivel. And his hands, due to how he transforms, kind of have movements a little bit. But his fingers can open and close. So that's cool. No waist movement. I mentioned the head can rotate. The legs, you have to move his little skirts up a little bit. He can get his legs going pretty far up and about that far back. These knees can fold back pretty far, and they can even fold forward for a little bit, so you can have some really weird kick going on. And his toes, I feel like I shouldn't even really mention that as articulation. It doesn't feel like it really should be articulation. But there you go. That's where all the engineering went. This thing really came later. This guy just looks neat. I like this guy. And of course, you can give him weapons. So you can give him the little gun here. You have to flip out the handle. And it's kind of tricky to get it in his hand. There is a little notch. And I'm not sure how well you can see. There's a little notch in his hand inside that fits the gun. You have to kind of work it past his fingers. And I don't know if I can really show that off because it's tricky to do when you're not trying to show it on camera. But once you get it lined up, you can close his fingers around and give him the saber laser, which I believe it's called. But the one downside is the way his arms are designed, they have this curvature to him, so he cannot hold his gun facing straight on. It's always at this angle, and you kind of have to bring his arm out a little bit more, if I can get it going. You can't have him holding his gun straight, and that really does bug me. I don't like giving him the gun because he can't hold it right. He holds it. Can you imagine trying to shoot someone, and then you start aiming off in that direction? That's just, look at that. What are you doing? What are you doing? You have to angle it there. That's a little better. So the gun, I like it, but it works a lot better for the Star Saber mode. Of course, I need to get his little hilt out of here. And then I need to get the little blade out of the front. There's that. These just slot together very, very easily. Same thing with the hand. There is a little notch and a little divot in his fingers that you have to kind of work around. But once you do, he holds it like a champ. That is such a better look than the gun. This really does work best for this mode. He can kind of wiggle his hand around. There is a rotation in his wrist, I forgot to mention, so you can have his hand moving around, protecting himself. But that just looks so much better. And if you want to get really, really crazy, you can take out that blade, put this back in there, get that out there, and just give him this because whatever. You can do it, but that works a lot more for the actual Star Saber configuration. So I'm going to go ahead and pull that off, put that back inside there, close that up, get rid of this little hilt, put that over there, and then get this all set up. One thing you can do before I do get to actually transforming him, you can actually take this guy and have him stand on the back of the V-Star, kind of like how he would in the show, because I have watched some episodes. I've given it a chance. You can have him riding it and posing him as if he's about to attack, and it's a cool thing that is quite obvious you can do it, but I thought it'd be nice to show it off. And before I do get to the actual combined mode, Something I saw that really made me go, oh, that's cute, is you can turn this thing into the battle station mode that at least the toy could. I'm not sure if it was in the show. I'm assuming it was. But all you do, take off the little stand. Again, you just gotta just pry it off. And I saw this, someone posted this on Twitter, and I'm sorry that I don't know who it was. But it's kind of a neat little thing that I can't tell if it was intentional or not. But you can do it. So to get this guy transformed, you're going to go ahead and start by taking the legs and unpegging them from the hands. When you do that, it brings them down. And you could go all the way down for the robot mode, but we're going to stop about halfway. We're not going to go all the way there just yet. Repeat with this side. Give it a nice little tug. There is a this little peg pegs into the hand, and that's what holds it in place quite securely. So you get that all loosened up. Go ahead and bring the arms forward so the guns are facing like that. Go around to the back, and it really helps if you pull the swords out. I have not tried this with the swords in place out of fear of breaking the swords or chipping them. So I go ahead and take them out, bring the head forward just for now. This whole little panel, you're going to undo it and flip it so it's like this. So it has this little platform that has a nice little stability factor on it. So for the legs, you're going to kind of bring them out a little bit. And that one, let's try two clicks just to be safe. And the legs are going to go just like this, just like that. And you kind of have to get it sitting like this. It does help if you actually fold the wings back all the way. And that's essentially it, at least for now. And it's kind of stable. It does flop a little bit. Obviously, when you put a saber on the back, it'll become very, very back heavy. So what you can do, you can take the little stands, pull up this part, flip it around, and then bring it back around this side and kind of put it so it's under that panel just to add a little extra support in the back. Obviously, this isn't something that you're going to be really moving around a lot. This is just a battle station mode that you would leave sitting on a shelf and not really doing much with it. But there's that. Got to open these guys up. Of course, you can take Saber. And he should be able to stand right on the back. So again, oh no, he fell. It's definitely not the sturdiest thing in the world. It kind of falls apart at the slightest touch of it. You really just want to put this on the shelf and not mess with it. If you even want to have this configuration going. I think his wing came undone. Let's try that now. Let's see how that looks. Are you going to stand? Yeah, there you go. So there you go. There's the battle station mode. I think it's cute. I think it's nice. You can actually do this. You can reenact this feature of the original toy. And yeah, I like it. I'm not going to use it, but I like it. So to get this guy fully transformed into Star Saber, go ahead and finish the legs. Bring them down all the way. Once you get them down here, you have to rotate the thigh. So this kind of, it looks almost like a notch is facing forward. And that will allow you to have the knees. So you got to do that. So repeat with this side. Fold this around or rotate around. There's that. I'm going to take the feet, fold them out. Whoop. Whoop. Now, these little thrusters, they're on a hinge, and they actually move, but I cannot find a reason why. They kind of work in the same pose for both robot mode and vehicle mode, so I don't know why they're supposed to move. The instructions don't mention it. I have no idea. I just leave them flat down just to give them a nice sturdy heel. And get his legs straight. There's that. Get that ratchet fixed. I have one ratchet a little too far. There we go. Get his knees all straight. He's all bent funny. There you go. He's a little back heavy currently, so we gotta kind of work around that. But from there, take the arms, fold them flat back down. Leave all of this where it is for now. It'll come into play later on. You're going to take these, extend the elbows all the way out. Extend that elbow all the way out. And you are ready to put in our buddy. This guy's big. But this is how he scales. Saber next to Star Saber. And here's a tip for you guys if you're making your own videos. If you take a break to do something, make sure you turn your microphone back on before you start recording again. Because I didn't. But anyway, to give a better idea of how big Saber is, here he is next to MP10. And you can see just how these guys all scale together. I think they look quite nice together. I do. He is tiny. He's about a tall deluxe, maybe even a Voyager, you could almost say. So He is rather small. He is rather big. He's just nice and perfect. I like this guy a lot. So to continue on, to put this guy into the final Star Saber mode, you're going to take off his little nose cone. Go ahead and fold that little flap up. You're going to take the hands. You're basically going to transform this guy back into his jet mode, stopping just a little short. So you take the hands, fold them all back up, bring them down to his side as they were. There's that. Go ahead and fold his feet up. Again, I like to do these with the legs separate. You can do it with them closed, but I find it easier when they are separate to kind of manipulate them. You're going to push them up only so that the yellow squares are visible, and they will stop. So if you give a little push, you got to kind of get it started. They kind of stop on their own right there, just like that. Then you can peg them together, and you can bring... Me, personally, I like to do the front first. Get those going as far as you can. And then again, take the little skirts up, flip them, and then bring the legs up again. Those ratchets are just so incredibly strong. And you get it there. I like to just give an extra push just to make sure everything is as high as it can go. And I think I'm actually there. So that's good. And that's kind of one of my complaints. You can't really peg in this at all. It doesn't lock in place. It just kind of hovers there. And it kind of, I can't help but wonder if the ratchets were reversed, if it would help, because if you're kind of manipulating Star Saber and you grip him by the chest at all, you're going to separate it from his body. I wish there was some kind of mechanism that would flip around to hold this in place, but it's not there. So you go back to the big body. Again, you're going to use this button. I'm not sure how much it ultimately helps the whole conversion process. It does help a little bit, but you're going to push that to work that little lever. And you're going to start by putting Saber inside, try to get him lined up in there. And then once it feels like he's in place, just give a little push on one side and he should start sliding in. Now, it is kind of tricky to do. And it kind of helps for me personally if I'm putting him in or taking him out. If I take one of the arms and kind of bend it outwards a little bit just to give a little added clearance, I find it helps. It may not help you at all, but it does take a little bit of pressure to actually push Saber all the way inside. And you can tell because the cockpit will actually fit into this little groove of the blue panel. So I take these little panels. They're going to flip over and go inside there. That's going to stay up. You can fold those out or you can leave them kind of pushed back if you want. I like going for this look. But that is actually kind of cool on its own. And I like that Star Saber actually walked around without his helmet in the cartoon. It's kind of like his casual. He's not ready to fight. He's just lounging around. He's hanging out with his buddies. Get him kind of tilted back a bit more. But of course, he needs the helmet. He is Star Saber. What is Star Saber without his helmet? And this is actually a neat gimmick that they didn't have to include, but it's on this little hinge mechanism. So you bring the helmet up, you bring it around his head, you kind of line it up and you push it on so it'll flip his face down. And then you can undo this little clasp in the back to pull this up, tuck it back into his body, boop, like that. And you take his little antenna, flip them up like that. You can get them kind of spread apart. Go back to this back panel and you're going to undo it, bring it up. It's going to peg in place like that. Then you undo this little panel back here. That's going to come up and that pegs in place. And there you have Star Saber. All transformed, all combined, and looking really, really nice. Yes, he doesn't really fit with the other Masterpiece Transformers at the moment. If you put him next to Optimus, for me personally, I think he looks cool. But he doesn't match their aesthetic at all. He's totally his own thing. And I would love if we could get more Masterpiece figures from Victory. I would love to get Victory Leo. Can you even imagine a God Genrai, if that's even how you pronounce his name? Who knows? I don't know. I would love if they would do more of this guy, less of these types. I'm going to be honest. I'm getting kind of tired of having the G1 core guys having Masterpiece. It's turning into its own classics line at this point, which I know people love. I know people love having Wheeljack and Trax and Bumblebee and Sideswipe and all of those guys, Prowl and Masterpiece scale. But it feels like it's not as fun anymore. It's just Optimus made sense. Some of the other guys, it's kind of questionable. I would love if they did more. I want to say obscure only because not as many people over here know who this guy is. Do this guy. Bring more of these to it. Make Masterpiece fun again. This guy made Masterpiece fun. Whether or not you like his robot mode, he does have that kind of 80s robot Gundam kind of vibe to it. he's just fun on the shelf, and he looks great. He's a fantastic-looking robot. That's enough of that little tangent. Articulation-wise for him, he has quite a bit. Again, the little skirts move a lot more, so you can bring his legs very far forward. Not so far back, because these actually, those don't move. So you can get them about that far. Heavy ratchets for his legs. They can swing out to the sides. That's also a skirt, I think. No, it's not. The legs can only swing out that far. But there's that. They can rotate at the thigh. They can rotate at the knee. The knee can bend quite a bit. The foot has movement to where it can actually swing forward. And this is actually ratcheted too, which I like. His ankles actually have ratchets. And he does have that kind of tilt, which really helps with his posing. He looks better when his legs are kind of spread apart and you have his feet kind of tilted inwards like that. I think he looks better like that instead of just having his legs straight down like that. You need to have some stance going. Surprisingly, he not only has a slight waist turn, he has a little bit of front and back motion. If you look, it's more so of an ab crunch going forward than back. But you can get that going on, which I really didn't expect. But he also has this little tilt side to side. So he has a lot of posability, given that he has this gimmick where a robot fits into his chest. There's a lot going on with him, which I really didn't expect. You go to the arms, full rotation. They can swing out to the sides a little bit. He has a double elbow joint, one which is held by friction, one which is a slight ratchet, and they were kind of loose for mine. If you have him staying just like this, he's perfectly fine. If you start giving him swords and shields, it does weigh down his arm, and it can't really hold that pose all too well. Oh, there's that one went down. So, me personally, I took this one apart. I put in some pledge, and it made it a lot stronger. He actually holds his shield without it actually falling now. So, it made it a lot sturdier. So, if you do get this guy, there are two little screws in this that you can take apart. Put in some pledge, it'll work fine and dandy. Make him so he can actually hold his weapons and not have his arms just collapse on him. But he does also, as you saw, he has that rotation joint above his elbow and below his elbow, and his wrists can swing a little bit and they can rotate, and his fingers are articulated only with like one joint though, which I think is perfectly fine. However, he does have more posability. I'm going to get this kind of pushed back. This will help a lot more when I actually have the double sword in play. But you can actually unclip his shoulders. And it does take a lot of force. The first time you do it, it feels like you're going to break it. But you got to just get those undone. And that will allow you to have his arms angled a lot more. So you can get in a lot better two-handed sword holding positions. I don't know if that's the right term. But so that is really cool. That's something that you really can't find unless you really mess this guy. It feels like you're gonna break it, but I will of course show that. And getting them pegged back in place is even more of a challenge, because it's just there you go. It feels like you're gonna break something, and you really don't want to. So there's that. Now for his accessories, he can store a few on his back. Get that open back up again. You go around here, the nose cone, that will be his hilt for the saber sword. You actually have this little notch right there that's gonna fit into the tab on his back, just like that. You can take his gun and store it right there. Me, personally, I like putting the smaller hilts over here, just kind of pegging that in place. The problem, of course, being is you can't store all three of his weapons on his body that I can find. If someone has found a way to store all three of these, aside from putting the gun up here and having this pegged in his butt, that's not going to work. That's just weird, and it makes him have a little dingly bob down here, which we don't want that. If you found a way to store all three of these in his robot mode, that would be really cool. Let me know. The way it was stored for its vehicle mode is in this little cavity, which is now filled in. That's not going to work at all. Get his feet flat again. But of course, you have the blades for his swords. I'm going to leave this one out because I'm going to be using it. You just open the little flaps like before. That fits in there. The swords do hang underneath him like that, and I actually will show this off. And it does make me a little worried when I'm actually posing this guy. I am kind of worried that I will grip the sword and bend it or do something with it. So when I am kind of playing with this guy, I do take the swords out. It's just personal preference. They do hang kind of low, but there's that. And you do have the shield, so you take this piece out. There is that. Nice little shield. And for the shield, his hands have, if I could try to show it off, it's kind of hard to do. His hands have that big groove, but they also have a little divot in the fingers. I'm not sure how well you can really make that out. Putting in his weapons is a little bit of a challenge. If you want to have everything fully pegged in, you have to kind of have his hands half closed and then just kind of try your best to get that in place. And it's, I have to do it from like certain angles and really just kind of play with it. Once you get his fingers wrapped around it, he can hold his shield, get his hand rotated. There you go. So there's that. You can hold his shield at certain levels. You can have it with just one elbow, with a double elbow. And I think he looks really good with a shield. Of course, you can have the sword. You're going to take this, fold this down, fold this piece up. That will allow you to bring down the handle for the hilt. There's that. That's going to go back down. You're going to open up this little tip of the nose clone. The nose clone? That's a nose clone, guys. I didn't know that. This little piece is going to fit inside there, aka in there. Close that up. And then you have the saber sword. And this is both... I kind of wish it was done differently. It's not bad, and it does fit in if you want to replicate the original toy. But if you have it with this hilt, he can only hold it one specific way, and that is like that. I'm not sure it's fully pegged in, but you get the idea. Which looks fine until you realize the blade isn't really facing forward. He's kind of stuck with this... Which, again, if you're trying to replicate the original toy, that's cool. That's how the toy looked. He held it like this. You can go ahead and take this. Go ahead and take that. Go ahead and fold this back up. Fold that down. Fold that down. Take this longer handle, and that slots right in there. And this does not peg into his hand. This is held it just fits in. And I close his fingers way too tight. Now, you can take that. And it's not a super tight fit. You have to kind of just essentially wedge as far as you can to his fingers and kind of slot it into this little collar bit. You can give him that. And see, when you move it, the sword just kind of flops around. This is made for the two-handed pose. But what I find neat, and I didn't see mentioned in the directions, I don't know if this was the intended purpose, but I noticed this thing, it's got a bunch of notches on it. And it's actually able to fit the larger blade. My theory is that this thing is to replicate the toy pose of the sword, to have it with the blade facing flat like this. This one actually fits in his hands so he can hold it properly. And again, helps you actually have the fingers wrapped around a certain way. Give me a second. There we go. It's basically a matter of trying to get these fingers lined up with the actual slots in the blade instead of the ones in the hands. It's something that I can't really explain. You have to see it in person to figure out how it works. But once you get that in place, that looks surprisingly good. Yes, he has a really small hilt for a sword, and it does look kind of off. But you can actually have a lot more poseability with this hand. You can do a lot more with the sword now in that position. So I kind of get the impression this was meant to replicate the animation model, how he held it in the cartoon, versus this one, which is done for the toy. But you can, of course, get these all switched back out. Let me go ahead and take his shield out. Now this might work, it might not. I've done this many times. Sometimes it looks really good. Sometimes it looks absolutely terrible. But get his hands not fully closed. That's kind of the trick. You have to have his hands partially open and get his elbows angled right. So you can take that, line it up in there. Try to squeeze his fingers around it. You can have him holding his sword like this. You can even bring his arms up a little bit. And again, it takes a lot of messing with it. It really does. You have to kind of get his arms angled. Get it about like that. Is that going to work? That might work. Let's see. That's not terrible. So you can get that going. You just tower over him. But as the box showed, you can also have him holding it kind of like that, which does not look bad at all. Honestly, in my opinion, this is the best way to have his sword when it's being held by two hands. Just kind of have it like this. It's not perfect. I think that looks cool. That is the best way to display holding a sword with two hands. That's my opinion. You can disagree if you want. It's perfectly fine. It's fine if you want to. I don't care. But I like that. I think that looks pretty cool. You can, of course, take the hand. You can take the hand that pegs back in. It's terrifying. Feels like it's going to break. There we go. And flip down the handle again. Get that in his hand. Get the fingers wrapped around it. And that works a whole lot better than just with Saber. I think that looks cool. And you can actually hold it straight. So, there you go. That is Star Saber. I think I've covered everything that I wanted to. I think. Oh, he does have added joints there at the side. There's so much posability in just his arms. And I think it serves strictly so you can have the two-handed sword pose. Oh, and also, I forgot to mention, his head. He does have slight movement where you can look up and down. And he still has a rotation due to the saber head inside. So, again, nice and posable. Quite a bit going on. And that is it. That is it for Star Saber. This is not a figure that most people will want to have. This is one that really a lot of people didn't want to win the fan choice whole thing. But I think he looks really cool. I have a fondness for just 80s robots in general. And this guy fits the bill perfectly. This guy made me watch Transformers Victory. And I'm going to watch more because I want to see more of this character. I think he is very, very worth it. And if you can find him for a good price, I think I paid around $120. Some sites still have it for $140. Unless you buy it domestically, then I think it's a bit higher. But he is totally worth it. And I don't regret my purchase one bit. All that's left now, I guess, is to transform back into his vehicle mode, because there are some things I want to point out so people don't actually break their toy. So for starters, go right to the back. Take this, fold it back up. Take this, fold it back down. I'm going to go ahead and take the blade from the saber sword and put it back inside there, because really there's no need to leave it out for transformation. Go ahead and take this little arm. It's going to fit back up and clamp it around the little notch. So then you can take the helmet, pull it off, and bring it back, and then fold the antenna forward like it was before. It's very familiar. This is very familiar for some reason. Now, when you're pulling Saber's body out of the kind of armor, it does take some kind of fooling around with. I have not found the perfect exact way to pull it out. The last time I did this, it actually got jammed in there. So I don't know really what I'm doing wrong. But as I mentioned, transforming this guy, it does help if you take one of the arms and just bend it back slightly. So you have to kind of get a grip and start pulling him forward. And I got one, and then there's the other. So there you go. That was the easiest time I have had taking this guy out. I think it is very, very worth it. And I'm realizing in my mistake of not having the microphone, these little guys do flip. I didn't show this transferring to Star Saber. I apologize. I tried to get everything back as it was. These, when you're transferring from Saber to Star Saber, you just flip them down to have the little gray vents visible. So that's the one thing I missed as far as I know. We're going to take this guy, of course, bring everything back down. Give a little push on the cockpit to bring the windshield back up. And then give a push to bring the thrusters and the tail section back up. Again, it's just, I find it easier to separate them. Let me get that. And then that one. Got to give a little push. There we go. Then get them lined back up. Peg them together. Get the wings down. Get those wings down. Get those up. Get on down. Get on up. And of course, take this little guy. Whoop! Bring it back down. He has this little notch above his crotch that I find helps when you're trying to pull him out, because you can't really get anything wedged back there. If you kind of hit that little notch, it pops him out. Not sure if intentional, but it's what I do, and it works for me every single time. Take the nose cone. It's going to fit back onto there. I'm going to go ahead and open this up so I can put you right back inside. And there is Saber transformed back into his vehicle mode, which is very, very easy. That's not what I really wanted to point out. Oh, and also there are little tabs on the hands that peg in to this back section to kind of add a little more stability. They don't peg in very, very well, and you have to make sure a gap forms in there very, very easily. Just give a really hard push, and it should clip in a bit better, and it lets you peg the hands in place. But there's Saber. Now for this guy, again, take the hands, push them up inside, push them up inside. For the legs, again, rotate them so this little notched, riveted kind of looking bit is on the inside, and then have the knees facing back out. And this is what I wanted to show you. Don't just bend the legs back to how they were. This little kind of slot right here that you may be able to see is actually a button. And when you push that, it lets you move the legs. So don't force this. just push the little button, and then you can bend the legs outwards. So just like that. And then from there, get that back undone. The hand's gonna fit inside this little groove. This, you have a peg and a little tab. Those are gonna fit all around the hand, just like that. Gotta give a really good strong push. So there's that. Go around to this side, repeat. Again, this is very hard to do looking through a viewfinder. And just give a little push, make sure everything is kind of compressed together. You can take this bit, get it pushed back flat. It helps you kind of have the legs spread apart. There are little tabs inside there that help hold this in place. So once you get that all lined up, give a nice hard push. It doesn't tab together super well. It just kind of fits. But you have these little tabs that fit underneath the lip of the legs. And they're meant to add stability to it. Sometimes they work, sometimes they don't. I find that after I get them kind of tabbed in, I have to go back and kind of push up on that blue part to see, make sure it's fully under that lip. But once you do that, it should hold together pretty securely. I did off camera because it's hard to work with a camera. And then of course, take the wings, fold them down, fold those up. There's that. Go around to the feet. They're just gonna collapse it on themselves, just like that. And then take these little landing gears, go ahead and bring them out, because that's how I want to end all of this. There's that. Get out of there. So yeah, that is it. This video was a lot longer than I intended to be, and I'm terribly sorry. I guess I can kind of justify it being that it's a masterpiece figure and took a little more effort to actually transform. I don't know. But there you go. There's Star Saber. All back to how he should be. And I recommend it most definitely. This is a really cool toy to have. And the transformation does feel solid. There are a couple moments where it feels like you're going to break something. And that's mainly with like folding the arms out for the two-handed pose and putting this thing into the body. But if you're careful the first time, the more you do it, the more you're going to get used to it. And as you saw, he came right out that last time. That's the best he's ever done. And I think that's really all that I can express. So I'm going to go ahead and put that in there, get that flipped around, take this, put it up there, and they're getting ready to dock. So that is it for this video, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope those annotations to skip the transformation were actually handy for you. I know a lot of you don't care to see the transformation, so hopefully that will be a help. There you go. Nope, I did not flip the face up. Oh, what am I going to do? There we go. But I will see you around. Thanks for watching as always, and take care. Bye.